Hey guys, so just my review so far of the season and things I think we need to improve on. Well, I think we had a great start to the season, not lost a game, and I'm wondering, it might not happen, but there's a possibility it could. The year before we got Van Persie, we went unbeaten. He's just gone. Can we go unbeaten again? It's a possibility. I think we can, especially if we beat Southampton and Chelsea. I think we'll beat Man City. But anyway, the first game was 0-0. We had so many shots. We were so good. Cazorla, first Premier League game, Podolski and Giroud, and Cazorla got man of the match. He was just amazing. Second game, Cazorla got man of the match again, I think. But we drew both of them 0-0, so that was pretty gutting. The first game, I think we played so much better. The second game, better than the other team, and the second game too. I think we were just amazing, and we wasn't lucky we didn't score. I think Giroud, you got to give him a chance. You do miss that chance, but you can't blame him because they're new to the Premier League. It's like you going from England to Spain. You've got to get used to the atmosphere and what it's like around there. So you've got to forget about what England has, and then you've got to see what Spain has. You've got to focus on that to get used to it. That's what they've got to do here with football. They've got to forget about where they came from, come to Premier League in England, and then they've got to try and see how different this is. But I think he's more of a high ball player. He likes the high balls. I don't think we play that, so I don't think he'll be good in that way. So we'll have to get used to something else, but I think he'll come good. Podolski, he is amazing. I think he'll score a fair few goals this season. I've kept faith in him and Cazorla. I've kept them in my dream team from the start. I know it's not related, but I've that's how much faith I have in them. People planning me to take them out, but I've kept them. Podolski, to see his goal, it was pretty cool, well taken. Cazorla, his goal was amazing as well, against Liverpool, 2-0. I think that was amazing, and the best thing is, my brother is a Liverpool fan. So, we had a £5 bet, and he owes me a fiver. So I'm going to get a video of seeing him admitting Arsenal that are better, and see him giving me the fiver. It's pretty cool, because I was happy, and I'm also going to see Arsenal-Chelsea on the 29th of September. So, yeah, there's going to be a fair few bit videos from that game put onto YouTube for you guys to watch. I'm going to hopefully get some people chanting Ashley Cole's 10 men went to bed, cunt went to bed with Ashley, etc. Hopefully get some songs and stuff that Arsenal we're singing there, beloved Arsenal. Can't wait to go watch them. I've got my tickets. Cost me £75. I'm going with my mate Simon. This review so far, I think we've done great. I think we can improve. The defence is solid. I think the new improved players, like last year when it was Song and RVP, and then the year before, etc., etc. I think this year it will be, not including our new signings, no, because I think they'll do great. And they've got to get used to it as well, which Cazorla and Podolski's already got used to it. I'm saying Diaby, one to watch out for. Jenkinson is another. And Mertesacker. They're the three I would say to watch out for this season. They're coming up. Our defence is solid. Steve Bold, you're doing a great job, man. You're doing only team not to have conceded a goal. Best defensive record in the league. Yeah. Could we go unbeaten? That's the question. The players got to keep their mind in it. Everyone on transfer deadline day was like, oh, no, Wenger, you got to sign somebody. Why aren't you signing somebody? And they're going mad, and they're like, ah, oh, it's time for Arsene Wenger to get out. Have you seen what he's done? Not conceded a goal, and got not let us lose a match yet. Doing great. Don't need no new signings. He's made three quality ones. RV Pussy, who is he? Don't know who he is. Gone to Man United, scored them hat-trick, made them win the game. Weren't for him, then yeah. I will admit, even though as much I hate to say it, he's a world-class striker. But he's had seven seasons at Arsenal. And Arsene Wenger's kept a faith in him. We all have. One good season and thinks, oh, we're not going to win trophies. We'll go somewhere else. Because he's worth something. That one season, he's worth something. So he thinks, oh, I'm worth something now. I can go somewhere else. But seven seasons before, he was like, I don't think I'm not worth anything. No, I'm going to stay here. Titles was never a problem then, was it? Trophies was never a problem then. But then this one season, when it comes good, oh, trophies is a big important matter. Fuck off, Van Persie. I even think Nasri's a better player than you. Well, not a better player, but yeah, I prefer him than you. Anyway, off the subject, Arsenal, 0-0 against Stoke. I was happy at that. I thought it was a tricky game going to Stoke. Not great at Stoke, I mean, and then tricky game at Liverpool, Anfield. We have won more games at Anfield since March something. To this date, than Liverpool have. That's how bad they are. Man, all my friends are Liverpool supporters, and I'm like, yes, stop taking the piss out of Arsenal. History, in the past, we've won more Premier League titles than you have. You've won fuck all, mate. Yeah, anyway, Sunderland are pretty disappointed. We were all over them, but at least we didn't concede a goal. Oh, and that Marion, or whatever his name is, the goalkeeper, he will be like Chesney last season when he came up and played amazing. He'll be good. But, yeah, I think, personally, we will do good this season. I think. I'm still saying top three, top two, maybe even win the league. I reckon that my top four are Chelsea, Arsenal, Man City, Man United, in that order. I know it's probably not going to happen, that order, but I hope Chelsea don't win the league. I hope we do. But this is our year, guys. This is our year. Don't stop believing in Arsenal. Don't stop believing in Arsene. Stop believing in the board if you want, because they're a bunch of pricks. They're a bunch of pricks. I don't like them. They can fuck off. But never, ever give up on Arsenal or Arsene. He is, what I'm saying, the best manager in the world. Other than Sir Alex Ferguson. They're both top managers. He's amazing. And never give up. But yeah, guys. My next video is hopefully going to be a Diaby chant. A Diaby chant. Maybe another Podolski chant. But I'm just going to get help from my mate, who's going to help me make some chants. He's a really good guy. Sound guy. And yeah, so we're going to get chants. And the music you hear in these videos and some of the chants. But this video, the music was made by Mitchell. So yeah, big up to him, thanks mate. And if you want a shout out, just follow me on Twitter. Subscribe to me and I'll give you a shout out if you help me and stuff. Thanks everywhere, guys. Thanks for your respect. I know people don't like me, but that's the problem. I'm like, Mom, you either love me or hate me. And if you hate me, well, jog on, because I couldn't give a damn. Because life not worth hating. It's you gotta make the most of it. Yeah, you gotta make the most of life. You gotta pay your respects to people. You don't treat people badly, it's wrong. But anyway, Arsenal, come on, Gunners. Gunner till I die. I'm a Gunner till I die. I know I am. Yes, I am. I'm a Gunner till I die. Come on, Arsenal. Thanks, guys. See you later. Follow me on Twitter. Like, subscribe. Thanks. Peace.